Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
The next one, let's move on to Mazhar Farooqi, who is from Gulf News. This was what was said to Mazhar. Vinod Kumar says, Mr. Mazhar could have also criticized Indian Muslims, not Islam, instigating tensions, which they purposely did to hurt some other religion feelings, which is true, but he can't do that because he is in a Muslim country. That's what we call balance in journalism. Well, even if he does that, Gulf News is not going to publish. Why? Because you have people from the ministry, Emiratis, who are there, they will not allow this to be published, okay? Not to make a particular community happy by his work. So, cannot support his actions, but that cannot justify any death threats to journalists. Actually, the death threats may be done by Muslims itself to make chaos and confusion in the situation. Yeah, well, you may have a point, okay? Some people can do that. Next one is Mabel5466 says about Mazhar and Gulf News. Loy, I too can vouch for Mazhar's integrity and professionalism. I too know him from the days he was part of Nirmala Jensen's Express team. Ah, okay. Express newspaper. Okay. He is a very good investigative journalist. Of course, he's the best. After being absorbed in Gulf News, he had to follow the editorial policies of Gulf News. At one time when Bikram Bora, I don't know who's that, and later Francis Matthew were the editors. I have no idea who these people are. Gulf News was very balanced in its coverage. The editorial policy of Gulf News changed when Mohammed Mezhel took over as managing director. I don't know who's that guy. He made it pro-Pakistani and anti-Indian. Ah, okay. That is because he's close to Pakistani establishment. Duleep George, who headed the marketing and advertising department, I don't know who's that, had warned about the board of directors about the paradigm shift in editorial policy. Moreover, I think this guy must have worked for Gulf News. He knows so much of the inside. Moreover, the pro-Pakistani editorial policy of Gulf News did not go well with the Indian business community. Slowly, they stopped advertising Gulf News. Big mistake, Gulf News, you're going to get fucked. Today, due to the lack of advertising revenue, Gulf News is pleading the government for a bailout, which they are not going to fucking care. Gulf News is a perfect example of how profit-making venture can be destroyed by faulty policies. The print edition of Gulf News is soon going to be history. The online edition will huff and puff for a few more years. Now, with more than 30% salary cut of Gulf News staff, zilch advertising revenue, higher operational costs, and with more redundancy on the anvil, the writing is on the wall. The day is not far when Gulf News will kick the bucket. So Loy, start writing the obituary for Gulf News. Someone from inside Gulf News has shared this, so I don't know who this is. Anyway, thank you so very much. Finally, Lenson Oliveira says, Loy, please note Gulf News has become Pakistani mouthpiece. They are using B.R. Shetty to show Indian negative and create rift with the ruling government. Sorry, Gulf News subscription has fallen 30% on year near to close because people realized it's speaking negative about the Indians and casing Indians poorly. Okay.